Hi, John here. This evening is Thursday 21st of July 2016 and we're just quietly sitting in front of the fireplace on the beach at Port Awanui. It is now about 7 o'clock in the evening and we had the owners on the leashes on getting a 11 here come and see us, and it was very good. I was quite happy that we met here on the beach, and we can go ahead with our plans for the hearing a 12 block to go on it earlier than the lease expires with Debbie and Leslie and Richard Fisher. We will have a meeting on the Te Horo Marae booklet for an owner's meeting on that block on Port Awanui Road, at the end of the road, just before Fisher's homestead. So we'll be talking about our plans, proposed plans for that block, for the owners, as well as other issues with the foreshore and seabed and our project plans for Ranfurly Bank, the Moai Tidal Energy Tidal Turbine Project. So that'll be discussed there, and with the hitting a 10 block, I've had some discussion with Leslie and Richard over that, and so they're quite happy for me to cut out the part where I want for quarry, for concrete, for building material, from breaking the hill down, and instead of reversion on growing trees around to hold the hill up. So this would have been more beneficial for the landowners to have some income revenue from that land block, at least for those shareholders. But I needed to put that to a meeting first with Te Tumutumu. It's in their control at the moment. So I need to talk to them about that. This is for our project with the tidal turbine energy and also building construction material and for retaining wall for erosion retention as well. So we've got that to discuss, as well as how we intend to use that block, the A12 block, at an A12 block, and to cut some out for our core business with the fisheries, deep sea fisheries on Ranfurly Bank, and also the tidal turbine platforms out there. So that'll be involved with the Marae, the Te Horo Marae, a big part to play on that, the foreshore and seabed that I'm well versed in legal native title, and also legal instruments around the retention of our lands and our ownership. And that's what Richard mentioned, something about keeping the land to ourselves rather than let it go through Te Tumutumu. They have issues with Te Tumutumu, I guess others have too. So I want to put that on high alert on our list of things to do, because I've only come into Te Tumutumu meeting on the A12 block, and I'm hearing concerns already about the other blocks we had a meeting on yesterday, the Arataha A1, Arataha A2, and Arataha B B2 blocks meeting. So I'm enjoying this fireside with Desmond here, and so he's a bit excited with what developments there was with the owners today, the leaseholders on the A12 block. So I'm happy as well. They came to see us here. I was a bit two-hearted from what Te Tumutunu said. I couldn't go on the block, and so far we're making mutual agreement to enter the block, and I need to tell Te Tumutunu that they've allowed us to enter the block before the lease is up, and we take the lease on the 30th of September 2016. So, but we'll be leaving them on the land to lease to carry on to raise their cattle while we're having the lease agreement between us and them to use part of the land as much as what we're using the rest part of the land for the business. We didn't need all of it. Okay, so this is, I don't know if you can see me on the camera, but anyway, I'm just enjoying myself in front of the fireside, and this black night, it's really dark out there, so there's no moon out tonight, and we're going to catch the sun in the morning rising, first in the east, and that's, we'll top our visit off here at Port Awanui, east of Ruatoria and south of East Cape Island, or Whanaukena Island, where the other land blocks are, the C12 block, and Rangitukia Haho 7B, just up on the other side of the Waipu River. We're on the south side of the Waipu River, not far down there, on this side, Tikapa side, or Tikapa towards Port Awanui. Beautiful place here, and we took some shots today of the area, and Richard could have taken us over the hill to the other side where I want to put the proposal to the council as a quarry to extract the hill material for building material, cement, earth homes. So that's for the property, the A12 block, and roads material, and also for retaining walls on the platform, the building material on the platform on Ranfurly Bank as well. So this brings more employment in this area for local, and also gives us an opportunity to start our long-awaited projects. So that, and that we have deep sea fishing as well, and aquafarms, which has been long coming. That's supposed to start on the C12 block, Marangaro C12 block, but I've delayed that until I got the government side sorted, and land blocks in Auckland and Waitangi, to be land blocks up north with the chiefs up there. So everything's going to be at the meeting discussed with the Confederation flag up in Waitangi, and Brexit, and our autonomy and self-management of our resources, natural resources and land. We want to keep our control of the land and control of the seabed, and that's what I want to explain from the marae point of view, as being a courthouse straight to Britain, UK, government and military. That's what we want to fit in with Brexit and our sovereignty, Admiralty, Court Martial Court in Waitangi, Treaty Grounds. So that's about all I want to say at this point in time, other than to call it a night and have a sleep in this wonderful chair, couch in front of this fire. Hope I don't catch on fire, but I don't think so. We've got to make going to keep one eye open, one eye closed, keep an eye on the fire, make sure that it's nice and warm. Otherwise, we would have been going back to Gisborne, but we're going to stay here and enjoy the surroundings and the sound of the ocean, and also the still dark night, and watch all those shooting stars going across the sky. It's a black night. It's supposed to be a wild night, but not so. It's been a wonderful day today, and it's been blue skies just about all day, and sunshine, nice and warm, and a long walk around the rocks. So that's all I want to say for now. We'll catch you in the morning when the sun rises. In the meantime, have a good evening. Bye for now. From Desmond and I, Port Awanui, East Cape.